experiment is the dielectric constant of a capacitor. So now I will give the demonstration of this experiment. The aim of the experiment is to determine the dielectric constant and a capacitance of a capacitor. The apparatus required for this experiment are an electrolyte capacitor, an voltmeter, a resistor, a two-way plug key, and a power supply. The formulas used in this experiment are: the capacitance of the capacitor is calculated by using the formula C is equal to T divided by R into log 2, which is equal to T divided by 0.693 R. And the dielectric constant of the capacitor is calculated by using the formula K is equal to C D into 10 power minus 6 divided by epsilon naught into length into breadth. The experimental circuit is as shown in the figure, which consists of a power supply, a capacitor, a resistor, voltmeter, and a two-way plug key. So the apparatus I'm using in this experiment are: this is the battery I'm using in this experimental setup, a capacitor and a resistor, a two-way plug key, a voltmeter, and the stopwatch. So now I'll move on to the experimental connection. The positive of the battery is connected to positive of the capacitor. The negative of the capacitor is connected to one end of the resistor. The other end of the resistor is connected to the center terminal of the two-way key. Then the upper terminal of the two-way key is connected to the negative of the battery. Then the lower end of the two-way key is connected to the positive of the battery and positive of the capacitor. Finally, the voltmeter is connected parallel to the capacitor. That is, the positive of the voltmeter connected to positive of the capacitor, and the negative of the voltmeter is connected to the negative of the capacitor. So that ends the experimental connection. So now I'll move on to tabulate the reading. So before tabulating, conducting, switch on the voltmeter or a power supply. Set 5 volt across the voltmeter. So that should be kept constant throughout the experiment. Then the voltage across the capacitor will be 0. So now set the stopwatch to 0 second. For that 0 second, the voltage across the capacitor will be 0. So later on, so we have two positions here. One is charging mode and the other one is discharging mode position. At a time, close the charging mode and start the stopwatch. Then for every 10 seconds, note down what is the voltage across the capacitor. Like this. So till 100 seconds, every time, note down what is the voltage across the capacitor in charging mode. And the readings are tabulated here. So you can observe here the nature of the reading. For 0 second, the voltage is 0. So for every 10 second, the voltage goes on, increases. Note down the reading till 100 second. So this is how to note down the charging mode reading. So after 100 second, start the stopwatch. Reset the stopwatch to 0 second. Then, so whatever the value you got for 100 second in charging mode, note down the same value for 0 second in discharging mode. So after that, you remove the key from the charging mode. So keep the key in the discharging mode. Simultaneously start the stopwatch. Again, for every 10 seconds, note down what is the voltage across the capacitor, and the readings are tabulated here. You can see the nature of the reading. So for zero, it is maximum 4.23. Then with the increase of time, the voltage across the capacitor goes on decreases, and we have noted the reading for every 10 seconds till 100 seconds. So after note downing both charging and discharging mode reading, so let us move on to the calculation part. Plot the graph by taking time along x-axis and voltage along y-axis. If you mark all the points, draw the freehand curve, you'll get a curve like this for charging mode. Similarly, mark all the discharging reading and draw the freehand curve, you'll get a curve like this for discharging mode reading. So both the curve will meet at a point of intersection. From the point of intersection, draw the vertical line to meet the time axis. Note down what is the time from the graph. It is found to be around, in this experiment, it is t is equal to 14 seconds. So from the experimental conduction, you'll get the value of t, which is equal to 14 seconds. So by using this t value, so let us calculate the capacitance of the capacitor. Using the formula, C is equal to T divided by 0.693 R. T, you are noted from the graph, which is 14 second. 14 divided by 0.693 R is the resistor used in the experiment, which is 10 kilo ohm, 10 into 10 power 3. Substitute all the values, simplify, the capacitance of the capacitor is found to be 2 into 2.02 into 10 power minus 3 farad. So then, the dielectric constant of a dielectric material is calculated by using the formula K is equal to C d into 10 power minus 6 divided by epsilon naught into length into breadth. C is the capacitance, which is calculated in the previous calculation, whose value is 2.02 into 10 power minus 3. D is the distance between the capacitor plates. It's a constant value given, which is 100 into 10 power minus 6 into 10 power minus 6 in the formula, divided by epsilon naught, permittivity of the free space, constant 8.854 into 10 power minus 12. L and B are length and breadth of the capacitor. They are given, constant value. So they are equal to 0.55 and 1.5 into 10 power minus 2. Substitute all the values, simplify, you'll get the dielectric constant of a given dielectric material in a capacitor is equal to 2.76.